Hi, my sweet nephews. I hope you're having a good day. So we're going to read the next chapter. And as I was thinking about the last chapter with Blackie Crow's plan to see if Farmer Brown's boy is afraid of Buster Bear, I thought of your books that you guys love, the Who Would Win books. And I thought you guys could think of a story. Who would win, Farmer Brown's boy or Buster Bear? And maybe that's kind of what Blackie Crow is thinking of. Anyways, that's kind of a fun little story to make up in your head. Or you could tell each other. Make up your own story and tell each other. And you could tell me too. I would love to hear your story. All right, we're going to read this next chapter. It's chapter 12. And it's called Farmer Brown's Boy and Buster Bear Grow Curious. Ever since it was light enough to see at all, Blackie the Crow had been sitting in the top of the tallest tree on the edge of the green forest nearest to Farmer Brown's house. And never for an instant had he taken his eyes from Farmer Brown's back door. What was he watching for? Why, for Farmer Brown's boy to come out on his way to milk the cows. Meanwhile, Sammy Jay was slipping silently through the green forest looking for Buster Bear, so that when the time came, he could let his cousin Blackie the Crow know just where Buster was. By and by, the back door of Farmer Brown's house opened, and out stepped Farmer Brown's boy. In each hand, he carried a milk pail. Right away, Blackie began to scream at the top of his lungs. "Caw, caw, caw!" shouted Blackie. "Caw, caw, caw!" And all the time, he flew about among the trees near the edge of the Green Forest as if so excited that he couldn't keep still. Farmer Brown's boy looked over there as if he wondered what all that fuss was about. As indeed he did. But he didn't start to go over and see. No, sir, he started straight for the barn. Blackie didn't know what to make of it. You see, smart as he is and shrewd as he is, Blackie doesn't know anything about the meaning of duty. For he never has to work excepting to get enough to eat. So when Farmer Brown's boy started for the barn instead of for the Green Forest, Blackie didn't know what to make of it. He screamed harder and louder than ever until his voice grew so hoarse he couldn't scream anymore. But Farmer Brown's boy kept right on to the barn. "I'd like to know what you're making such a fuss about, Mr. Crow. But I've got to feed the cows and milk them first," said he. Now, all this time, the other little people of the Green Forest and the Green Meadows had been hiding where they could see all that went on. When Farmer Brown's boy disappeared in the barn, Chatterer the Red Squirrel snickered right out loud. "Ha, ha, ha, ha! This is a great plan of yours, Blackie. Ha, 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 ha!" he shouted back. Blackie couldn't find a word to say. He just hung his head, which is something Blackie seldom does. "Perhaps if we wait until he comes out again, he will come over here," said Sammy Jay, who had joined Blackie. So it was decided to wait. It seemed as if Farmer Brown's boy never would come out, but at last he did. Blackie and Sammy Jay at once began to scream and make all the fuss they could. Farmer Brown's boy took the two pails of milk into the house. Then out he came and started straight for the great green forest. He was so curious to know what it all meant that he couldn't wait another minute. Now, there was someone else with a great deal of curiosity also. He had heard the screaming of Blackie the Crow and Sammy Jay, and he had listened until he couldn't stand it another minute. He just had to know what it was all about. So at the same time Farmer Brown's boy started for the Green Forest, this other listener started towards the place where Blackie and Sammy were making such a racket. He walked very softly so as not to make a sound. It was Buster Bear. That's the end of that chapter. The next chapter Chapter 13, Farmer Brown's Boy and Buster Bear and Buster Bear meet. What's gonna happen? Should I stop? Or do you want to know what happens? I'll keep reading. You can know what happens. If you should meet with Buster Bear while walking through the wood, what would you do? Now tell me true. I'd run the best I could. That is what Farmer Brown's boy did when he met Buster Bear and a lot of the little people of the Green Forest and some of the Green Meadows saw him. When Farmer Brown's boy came hurrying home from the Laughing Brook without any fish one day and told about the great footprint he had seen in a muddy place on the bank deep in the Green Forest and had said he was sure that it was the footprint of a bear, he had been laughed at. Farmer Brown had laughed and laughed. "Why," said he, "there hasn't been a bear in the Green Forest for years and years and years, not since my own grandfather was a little boy." And that, you know, was a long, long, long time ago. If you want to find Mr. Bear, you will have to go to the Great Woods. I don't know who made that footprint, but it certainly couldn't have been a bear. I think you must have imagined it. Then he had laughed some more, and all of which goes to show how easy it is to be mistaken and how foolish it is to laugh at things you really don't know about. Buster Bear had come to live in the Green Forest, and Farmer Brown's boy had seen his footprint. But Farmer Brown laughed so much and made fun of him so much that at last his boy began to think that he must have been mistaken after all. So when he heard Blacky the Crow and Sammy Jay making a great fuss near the edge of the Green Forest, he never once thought of Buster Bear as he started over to see what was going on. When Blacky and Sammy saw him coming, they moved a little further into the Green Forest, still screaming in the most excited way. They felt sure that Farmer Brown's boy would follow them, and they meant to lead him to where Sammy had seen Buster Bear that morning. Then they would find out for sure if what Little Joe Otter had said was true. That Farmer Brown's boy really was afraid of Buster Bear. Now, all around, behind trees and stumps and under thick branches and even in the treetops, were other little people watching with round, wide, open eyes to see what would happen. It was very exciting, the most exciting thing they could remember. You see, they had come to believe that Farmer Brown's boy wasn't afraid of anybody or anything, and as most of them were very much afraid of him, they had hard work to believe that he would really be afraid of even such a great, big, strong fellow as Buster Bear. Everyone was so busy watching Farmer Brown's boy that no one saw Buster coming from the other direction. You see, Buster walked very softly. Big as he is, he can walk without making the teensiest, weensiest sound. And that is how it happened, that no one saw him or heard him until just as Farmer Brown's boy stepped out from behind one side of a thick little hemlock tree, Buster Bear stepped out from behind the other side of that same tree. Oh my goodness. And there they were, face to face. And everybody held their breath. Even Blacky the Crow and Sammy Jay. For just a little minute, it was so still there in the Green Forest that not the least little sound could be heard. What was going to happen? Oh, that's the end of the chapter. We'll have to wait till next time to see what happens. The next thing is called A Surprising Thing Happens. I wonder what surprising thing happens. I'll be excited. I promise you I won't cheat and read ahead. We'll have to find out together. I'll see you next time. Bye.